I'm casually talking about what amounts to sexual assault. Well, he has apologized, and still a tidal wave of lawmakers are rescinding their endorsements of Donald Trump. That started on Saturday, and sources tell CNN those at the top of the GOP, including House Speaker Paul Ryan and Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, would prefer that Trump just step aside. All this is just ratcheting up the anticipation for tonight's face-off between Trump and Clinton. The Clinton camp has been relatively quiet in their responses to those 2005 tapes, but aides tell CNN expect that Hillary Clinton will bring it up early on in tonight's debate. Let's talk now with CNN politics commentators Tara Setmayer and Jeffrey Lord. Jeffrey Lord's a Donald Trump supporter. Tara Setmayer is not. Good morning to both of you.
All right, but we are friends.
Yes, you two are friends.
We are.
Jeffrey, let me start with you, because what we've heard from each of the Trump supporters is that he needs to be contrite tonight. He needs to apologize and then shift to the issues. That's what they want to hear. Donald Trump is not doing that, at least on Twitter. What he's retweeting, tweets from Juanita Broderick, a Clinton accuser from 99.
Right.
If that's what he needs to do, why isn't he doing that?
Well, I think he will do the first that you're suggesting, but I personally think the other is necessary. Look, these are the folks who are making a big deal about sex. I mean, the Democratic Party, these are the folks who do this. Hillary Clinton.
The Democrats are making a big deal about sex. I don't know if I have enough time right now to dissect and analyze that. But go ahead.
These are the folks. I mean, they're all upset about this sort of thing. This is a political party that rallied to Bill Clinton.
Go ahead.
Let me finish. That rallied to Bill Clinton when, and interestingly, the American people rallied to Bill Clinton because they did not think issues like this were important. They stuck with him. And I would submit to you that the American people out there that are supporting Donald Trump don't think this stuff is important either. It's the party elites. It's people who, the consultant class and all of that sort of thing, who have a problem with this. But average rank-and-file voters that I talk to, that come up and talk to me because they recognize me from CNN, these folks are passionate about this. They're not going anywhere.
What I'm seeing, though, is a difference, and Tara, I'll bring you in on this, in the difference between, and I think you're talking about the Lewinsky episode. Is that what you're discussing?
Right.
Okay, between that and this.
And Juanita Broderick and the whole conglomeration of issues.
Well, Juanita Broderick was in 1999, but the Lewinsky episode was consensual. What Donald Trump was describing was, I don't have to wait. I just jump on her like a, and I'm not going to use the word because of the hour, and that is essentially sexual assault. Tara, from your perspective.
Yeah, I think that the dismissing of what Donald Trump said is just, oh, these are just words. I think that is really missing the point here. No, they're not just words. If you listen to the way he's talking about women in this one clip, I mean, we've heard several others prior to this, but this one speaks as though he's already done it. He says, oh, they'll let you do anything, like grab them in the blank and all the things that, oh, yeah, I tried to effer. He's obviously done this before, and it was successful, apparently, the way he was bragging about it. That is concerning, and I would disagree that Americans don't care about this. I would say women who have been in situations where they have felt uncomfortable, where they've been in situations where they're sexually harassed, where they sexual assault victims. You know, I've had people reach out to me thanking me for standing up not only for sexual assault victims and women, but I've had men reach out to me to thank me to say, I've nursed my wife or my girlfriend through, the horrific events of sexual assault. And this is very real for them. So I think as Republicans and as conservatives particularly, those who went after Bill Clinton, and deservedly so for what he did in the 1990s, who are now trying to brush this off as if it's just some kind of random act and it's inconsequential, I think are hypocrites, because this is consequential. We're talking about the President of the United States and it's his character. It's not okay to be a sexual predator. And I don't know when Republicans all of a sudden decided that was something that was okay. It's not okay. And Donald Trump needs to be held accountable for it.
Of course it's not okay to be a sexual predator. We are we are talking about an accusation of rape. Of rape, for heaven's sakes, and that Hillary Clinton was an enabler, and that she bullied the woman who was accusing her husband of rape.
Okay,
and that
does that excuse Donald Trump?
And threatened her. Now, that is a big deal.
But
that is a big deal.
But here's the other element
here.
Every minute you speak, but But every minute you spend speaking about that, you don't go back to what all of Donald Trump's surrogates and supporters say are his winning issues are the issues of the economy and jobs and trade. The other thing is Bill Clinton is not on the ballot. Donald Trump is.
No, but it's the issue. It's the issue of can you do this stuff and get away with it? I mean, this is what Tara is saying is Donald Trump shouldn't be allowed to get away with it. If that applies to Donald Trump, it applies to Hillary Clinton because she was the enabler here.
All right, let me bring up something else here. Let's put the statement up, and I'm going to come right to this. Melania Trump. Let's put it on the screen, guys. Melania Trump, obviously Donald Trump's wife, released a statement through the campaign. The words my husband used are unacceptable and offensive to me. This does not represent the man I know. He has the heart and mind of a leader. And she goes on to say here, the only copy I have is what's on your screen. I hope people will accept his apology as I have and focus on the important issues facing our nation and the world. Jeffrey, every time you're on, you've got a Reagan story. I don't remember Nancy Reagan ever having to put a statement out condemning the words of Ronald Reagan.
Well, Nancy Reagan had to defend Ronald Reagan. I was in the White House during the Iran.
She didn't have to say, I'm offended by what my husband said through his campaign.
Look, they're different personalities and different.
Right. I mean, Ronald Reagan had class.
When I say that they're alike, I'm talking about politically and the kinds of folks that they appeal to. That's what I'm talking about. And the kind of enemies they have. Ronald Reagan's biggest enemy was the Republican establishment. They couldn't stand him. They couldn't abide him. And now they all pretend, how great he was and all this kind of stuff. I was there. They hated his guts.
For different reasons.
Well, Tara, this is stunning. We're getting this statement from Melania Trump, from Mike Pence as well. Through the campaign, these principals are condemning the words of Donald Trump.
His own vice president condemned him. This is unprecedented. And Jeffrey knows, we go back and forth about this all the time, that I feel that trying to compare Ronald Reagan and Donald Trump is a disgrace to Ronald Reagan's legacy, because Ronald Reagan was a class act. He was thoughtful. He was a convicted conservative. And he would he actually was believed in that the presidency was bigger than himself. Donald Trump is a narcissist, an egomaniac, and apparently a sexual pervert who disrespects women, who has a love affair with authoritarians, and who is just taking the Republican Party along for this disaster of a ride with his campaign. And unfortunately, he's leading a lot of the people who support him astray, because this is about his own ego trip, and it's not about the actual future of the country. So, you know, for us to sit here and say that it's just elites and people that are condemning Donald Trump, that's not necessarily true. People from his own, even in his own circle, cannot defend this, because they see that what Donald Trump is doing is, not only is he destroying the party, but this is bringing such disrespect to the office of the presidency that it's untenable. And we need to protect our Republicans down ballot and rebuild moving forward, because otherwise the Republican Party is not going to survive.
Tara Setmayer, Jeffrey Lord, thank you both. You all will be on air all day. So I know Jeffrey wanted to jump in there, but he'll have many opportunities up until debate time. Let's turn now to CNN Politics Executive Editor Mark Preston. And I want to pick up on